All right, welcome back. We continue live right here. Bob Pompiani, we got our cast. We're ready to go here with a lot of decisions, and I want to be specific with this stuff here now, guys. And Josh Jerry, we'll start with you, because Mike Tomlin did something that I never saw before, and that is down by 4 touchdowns at the 38-yard line of Cleveland, and he kicked, or he punted the ball away, which I didn't understand. But then later in the game, with an opportunity and the clear momentum on his side on a 4th down and 1, he decided to did he punt that one as well, or what did he do on that one?
He punted.
Yeah, he punted on both. My point was, the situation calls for urgency. You're down multiple points, multiple scores. Why punt on those situations if you're not living in your fears?
Well, in particular, Bob, in the fourth quarter, it was early in the fourth, right? They were up 13, beginning of the fourth quarter.
Right.
You have to go for it there. And you could sense it, even though I wasn't at the stadium, you could sense the Browns were getting a little tight. And the Steelers had so much momentum. They moved the ball quite easily in the second half. I realize it was against a prevent defense, but that was a little too much of a prevent defense. And the Browns absolutely let them back in the game. And I just don't understand how Tomlin could be conservative there, especially when you consider how horrendous the Steelers' defense was all night. If they had looked like they had a chance to stop the Browns, then maybe you understand it, but there's just some hypocrisy there. For a coach who likes to go for it as much as Tomlin does, and as aggressive as the Steelers often are, they had them on the ropes a little bit. You could feel it. It just made no sense to me at all.
No question, Josh. I 100% agree with you. I felt the momentum swing. I felt like this actually could be a comeback at the beginning of the fourth quarter, but obviously it wasn't. But you felt like it might have been. Like they were actually going to come back and maybe have a chance to win this, and they don't go for it. I don't get it. That I don't get, and I also don't get why they didn't go for 2 and try to make an 11-point game. That was a huge right there. What's the difference? 12 points? It's still three possessions, no matter how you cut it, even if you kick an extra point, kick a field goal to win it. They needed to go for 2 there, because 12 and 13, to me, is the same. You needed to get to 11.
That's an absolute one.
They went for 2 way too early, and that was stupid. Then they didn't go for 2 when they absolutely were supposed to go for 2, and that was stupid. Not punting in when you're down 28 to nothing and you're inside the other team's 40, that was stupid. However, it was not stupid to punt the ball when they did on 4th and 1 from the 50. They were down 12. It was the fourth quarter. There was 15 minutes left in the game. And unfortunately, if you remember, it's like we've never watched this team before. They were horrible all season long on 3rd and 4th and 1. All season long.
You know what, though, Paul?
What made you?
They were also horrible on stopping. They responded by scoring. They moved right down the field. The Steeler defense gave you no indication that they were going to be able to stop them.
The Browns went 3 and out 3 times in a row before that play.
I understand
that. What are we talking about here?
That's momentum.
They had stopped them three times in a row. Their defense was supposed to be their bread and butter. They had stopped them 3 times in a row. If you go for it there at the 48 or whatever it was, and you don't make it, the game is over. By punting, you're saying, I trust my defense to give us the ball back. We still have plenty of time to score 2 touchdowns. I cannot believe that is the decision that people are killing them for. There was about 5 or 6 other decisions earlier in the game that were far worse than that one.
I had no problem with that one. I'm talking about the other 4th down play they didn't go for. That's the problem I have.
I'm saying when it was inside the 40 and you're down 28 to nothing, you absolutely go for it there. And they punted. I hated that decision.
The 2-point conversion, not going for 2 there to make it 11, was the worst one. The worst one.
And I agree. Richie, you're not listening. I agree with all of that. And that when they had the ball at the 47, their own 47 or whatever it is, because here's the other thing. Okay, you go for it. You're still 50 yards away from a touchdown.
Yeah, but you
it's
have possession
like you
of the ball.
You go for it, you score.
You need as many possessions as you can get, and you had the momentum on your side. That's what I'm saying.
Exactly,
it seemed to stop your own your momentum. That's why.
But Bob, they went 3 and out 3 times in a row. Your defense had momentum. If you don't trust your defense in that spot, then your defense stinks. And guess what we found out?
It stinks.
Your defense stinks. They stink.
Hey, I think
they should have gone for it. It stunk all night. That's my point.
Right. So you would have gone for it, Josh, as I would have too.
I would have. I absolutely thought it would have been the right decision. You have to take chances if you're going to pull off a 28-point comeback. I just don't think being conservative is going to get it done against a pretty good team.
All right, I understand we have
Mike. I don't know that, but I don't know that that's conservative. That's my point. I think that's playing smart. If there's 8 minutes left, it's different.
I think this game was over on the first play of the game, guys. That's what I think.
But if there's 8 minutes left, it's different. But there was 15. You had a lot of time to score two touchdowns.
All right. They put themselves in a hole. It was so deep, you couldn't get out of it. Mike Tomlin, I believe we have some live post-game reaction from Heinz Field. Let's see if we can eavesdrop on that right now.
You mentioned assessing the cumulative, and Ben Roethlisberger and Marquise Pouncey were the last two that came off the field sitting together. When do you start having the conversation with Ben about his future and where he goes from here?
I hadn't thought about that, to be honest with you. You know, we've been in this play mode and this compete mode. And so, you know, those discussions and decisions regarding personnel and wrapping the ball around the season and getting an eye toward what the future looks like, those things will begin happening in the upcoming days and weeks.
Jim Colony.
Yeah, Mike, this is three straight seasons now, plus the Jacksonville playoff game where things have not gone well down the stretch. How should you be held accountable for that?
It is what it is, man. Our record is our record. Our performances are our performances. And so don't run away from that.
Jerry Dulac.
Hey, Mike, when you get behind right away on the first snap and it just unravels like it did in the first quarter, down 28, I mean, what did you say to the guys, and how do you try to keep them focused to try to come back?
You know, I wasn't worried about them being focused and trying to come back, but in terms of our urgency and things, but it does change the climate of the game in terms of opportunities and opportunities for splash and the nature in which they play and the nature in which we have to play. You lose balance. You miss opportunities for splash on the other side because they hide the ball, et cetera. It doesn't bode well when you spot people points, and particularly the way we did it tonight. It made the journey a difficult one.
Will Graves.
And that journey is now going to get even more difficult. We're going to take a break here. We'll dissect some of that. We'll also talk about future decisions that have to be made. Coaching, quarterback, running back, wide receiver. There are a lot of them. They have 20 unrestricted free agents. We'll get into that next right here live on the number one Cochran Sports Show.